Absolutely beautiful today. And Corey, you look, I've never seen this side of you. Today I have this honor of officiating this ceremony, but can we thank God real quick for bringing these two together? Anybody grateful? We get to see a step of faith like this. And so I want to share with you John chapter 2. The story of Jesus at a wedding, which is the perfect, I think it's the perfect moment to share the story. It says that Jesus' mother comes to him and she says, we're out of wine and I need you to step in and fix this problem for me. And so Jesus turns and addresses some servants who are standing by. It says, nearby stood six stone water jars, the kind used by the Jews for ceremonial washing, each holding 20 to 30 gallons each. Jesus said to the servants, fill the jars with water. So they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, draw some out and take them to the master of the banquet. They did so, and the master of the banquet tasted the water that had been turned into wine. He did not realize where it had come from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, and he called the bridegroom aside. He said, everyone brings out the choice wine first, and then the cheaper wine after the guests have had too much to drink. But you have saved the best until now. A few things about this that I think, who knows if you're gonna remember anything I say, and it's really okay if you don't. Just stare into each other's eyes and get lost in your love, okay? But I was thinking about three things in this story. Number one, Jesus is at this wedding because he's invited as a guest, which is remarkable because when I think of Jesus at a wedding, I think of Jesus officiating a wedding. Maybe because I'm a pastor, and so I think that way. But he's there not, we don't know if he's on the bride's side or the groom's side, he's just there because he's invited. And that's powerful to think about. That like of all the things Jesus could be doing, he wanted to be at this wedding. I think what that shows us is that when you invite Jesus into your life, he wants to be there. And he wants to be guest, he wants to be Lord, he wants to be involved in whichever way. He wants to be in your relationship. And you being here today and doing this, is you're telling everybody, I don't want to do this without him. So that's incredible. If you keep doing that, if you keep inviting him into your decisions and your choices and the moments, big and small, you're gonna see that he's the best thing that ever happened to your wedding and to your relationship and to those decisions. Number two, we see that there are 6 stone water jars. These are stone water jars. I don't even know how much they weigh, but I'm sure they're incredibly heavy. And that's about 180 gallons of water that is turned into wine. So that's a lot of trips to the well, or I don't think they had a water hose. It was a hassle. I mean, it was a lot of work to get all that water. And that would have taken a long time. And they did it though, and they obeyed him. They took the posture of a servant, they were obedient, and as a result, look what happened. They got to be a part of Jesus' first miracle, and the whole thing was changed because of them. I think beyond just putting God first in your life, listening to what he says, and saying yes to whatever he asks you to do. And sometimes you may not understand it. In fact, anybody in here ever have to follow God when you don't understand him? How about being married? Is there a lot of things that don't make sense right away, but you do it because you know it's his way? Yeah. And sometimes marriage work? Yes. I mean, this is the story of your relationship. But if you keep putting God first, no matter the hassle or the work, or you just keep putting him first, you're going to see God do something incredible with that faith. And you're going to see a miracle. The last part of the story here is the master of banquet like stops the ceremony. And he's like, have you had this wine? This is the best wine I've ever had. And surprise, surprise, when Jesus makes wine, it's the best wine anybody's ever had. When you invite Jesus into something, when you do it his way, when you obey him, you're in store for a miracle. And you're in this story. You see, you're the water jar. God wants to fill you up and to use you not only for his glory, but for each other and for the rest of the world, the good of mankind. God wants to do something in you and through you in such a way, in such a miracle, that people stop and go, have you seen that? Have you tasted this? What God wants to do in you and through you is going to be nothing short of a miracle. It's going to demand an explanation from all the people. It's demanding an explanation today that you would take this step of faith. And so I'm so proud of you guys, and I'm so encouraged by your faith today. And I want to read 1 Corinthians 13 about love. But do you have some rings?
What?
Okay, why don't you slide that ring over her finger and you go first. It's a sacred moment, Corey. First Corinthians 13 says that love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast. It says it does not dishonor others, it's not self-seeking, it's not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. I think the vows that I'm going to read in a moment really are just pointing us to how God defines love. This love is possible for you because God's going to empower you by the Holy Spirit to love her that way and for you to love him that way. That's the only way a standard of love like that can be realized, is with God's help. So I'm going to read these vows, and if you agree, you would say, I do. Okay? I'm going to read the whole thing. Do you, Corey, take Kara to be your husband, your wife, your constant, your faithful partner, your love from this day forward? In the presence of God, your family, and friends, do you offer your solemn vow to be a faithful partner in sickness and in health, in good times and in bad, in joy as well as in sorrow, Do you promise to love Kira unconditionally, to support her in her goals, to honor and respect her, to laugh with her, to cry with her, to cherish her as long as you both shall live? Do you, Kara, take Corey to be your husband? Do you have the ring? Let's put that on. Because the best part's right after this, so I want to make sure you can just... You gotta put it... You gotta... Just maybe the other finger. You don't want that... Yeah. There you go. Do you care to take Corey to be your husband, your constant friend, your faithful partner, your love from this day forward? In the presence of God, your family, and friends, do you offer your solemn vow to be a faithful partner in sickness and in health, in good times and in bad, in joy as well as in sorrow? Do you promise to love Corey unconditionally, to support him in his goals, to honor and respect him, to laugh with him, to cry with him, to cherish him, as long as you both shall live? Can I pray for y'all? If everyone bow their head and close their eyes. Lord, thank you so much, Cora and Kara. Thank you so much that from this day forward, they'll be able to look back and say, we know that we have aligned everything with God's word. I pray from this day forward, they would sense your presence and your power leading and guiding them. Lord, I pray that you'd use their marriage as a miracle, evidence of your goodness to everyone that would watch. Lord, I pray that their marriage would demand an explanation to the world around them of how good you are. Lord, I pray that you continue to change each one of them to be more like Jesus, to love and serve each other in a way that is only possible through the love given to us by you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
So by the power vested in me by the state of California, you may now kiss your bride. So for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Corey Kattan.
free. Awesome. They're right there.
Sometimes I wonder what you're holding on.
Come on,
get your drink. On top of me.
All right, I don't know.
You guys know, you guys know, awesome.
Hey, I saw you.
One, two, three.